هما الكافرين يعني. After them came the followers of Martin Luther. Martin Luther. He was a professor and a German theologist. عالم دين لاهوتي كان ألماني أصلا مارتن لوثر. And he called for the reformation of the church and that you should depend only on your belief, on your faith. Faith على الإيمان بس فقط هو ده طريق الصلاح. Not on rites, الطقوس or sacraments or whatever اللي ايه الحاجات اللي بتحصل in the church. You should depend only on your faith. And he accused or attacked indulgence اللي هي سك الغفران, سكوك الغفران اللي هي indulgence اللي بيديوها religious men أو church men to everyone who is penitent, واحد عايز يتوب فيدوله indulgence سك غفران ليه. فقال لهم the only way is his faith and his repentance, توبته. ما ينفعش to give him indulgences اللي هي سكوك الغفران. So Martin Luther, الكلام ده كان لو تفتكري in 1917. And I say to you in 15, Henry the Eighth تولى in 1509. Martin Luther كتب الكلام ده in 1517, في 17. اوكي يعني هنري ذا ايس هيم سيلف اتاكد هيم قبل ما يبقى المطر برايفت بالنسبه له and he wanted divorce. He attacked Martin Luther and his call for the reformation of the church. الكلام ده في سنه 17 يعني كان متولي هنري في سنه 9 قبله بقد ايه. لكن لما جه الامر يتعلق with his private matter and his divorce, he called also for the reformation of the church. So the common man cannot have a wish or any matter or the matter بالنسبة لهم, they don't care or didn't care for the matter of divorce. ما يهمهمش قوي matter of divorce, وخصوصا ال common man والserfs والطبقة ال low class in England. أمال هو هيتكلم في ال parliament according to what? According to the corruption of the church. يعني المدخل بتاعه هو وتوماس كرومويل مش هيكون to achieve divorce, no, to reform the church. Okay? يبقى هما لما يتكلموا توماس كرومويل هيتكلم اساسا the corruption of the church, not in order to achieve the divorce of the king. فهو خدم الكينج خدمه كبيره قوي قوي علشان عن طريق مهاجمة الـ corruption of the church. كلام ده حصل طبعا. توماس كرومويل was a soldier and was a tradesman, كان تاجر. He made many tours in Europe. فطبعا he had a good background about the reformations and the ideas of the reformation. لف أوروبا وشاف في جيرماني ان مارتن لوثر بيقول كذا وده بيقول كذا, فعنده أفكار ممكن يكون يهاجم how to attack the church. In 1530 دي بداية الكلام. In 15 نتابع مع بعض بقى. In 1529 he attacked the corruption of the church. أول بدايته in the parliament, في البرلمان أول حاجة اتكلم على the corruption of the church. الكلام ده كام؟ 29. أوكي. In March 1532 March 1532 في 32 he encouraged the representatives of the parliament in order to have attack against the abuses of the churchmen. فكتبوا ايه بقى؟ كتبوا كده حاجة طويلة كده. The abuses, الاتهامات اللي هم موجهينها للتشيرشمن, سموها the commons supplication against the ordinaries. The commons supplication against the ordinaries. اوكي. سبليكيشن ده بيقول ان التشيرش من كلهم او بعض منهم some of them were corrupted and there was corruption in the church and should be reformed. تمام الكلام ده in March 1532. اوكي okay. All the convocation اللي هي legislative body in the church كلهم الكليرجي من اللي موجودين في الconvocation in May 1532 يعني بعدها بكم شهر الconvocation سي كابيتال what was convocation legislative body of the clergy men in the church. التعريف بتاع convocation legislative body of the church men or the clergy men in the church. الconvocation كتبوا the submission of the clergy. The submission of the clergy بمعنى ان هم خاضعين للملك. The king can agree or disagree for any legislative matter. اوكي okay. اسمها ايه الوثيقه دي؟ اسمها submission خضوع. تمام submission of the clergy. According to this document اللي وقع عليها كل ال convocation ان the king can agree or disagree for any legislative matter of the convocation. يعني يقول لهم اه او لا، انا موافق او مش موافق. معنى كده ايه بقى ال what is the meaning of this that the king became the head of the church. خلاص according to this submission كلهم خضعوا له. تمام بس ودي النقطه اللي كان عايز يوصل لها توماس كرومويل. اوكي ففعلا كلهم ما يقدروش ياخدوا اي قرار without him. So in December 1532 نتابع مع بعض السنوات بقى لان هنا هتيجي الظروف متلاحقه after that. In December 1532 and Walin declared that she was pregnant. 32 in January 1533 King Henry VIII declared his marriage or married legally and Walin لأن هو بنفسه اعتبر he considered that his marriage from Catherine of Aragon is invalid منه نفسه. اوكي الكلام ده في جانيوري 1533 يناير 33. اوكي then in spring على ما جه الربيع كده يناير spring the parliament had an act اسمه ايه بقى الاكت ده act restraints of appeals. Of appeals. ايه الاكت ده؟ بيتكلم عن ايه؟ Restraint of appeals that you cannot go to any in any case in the church or to the church of Rome. يبقى ما تقدرش تروح تلجأ to the Pope or the church of Rome in any matter, in any appeal, in any case. امال تروح فين؟ The church of England. معنى كده ان ده another declaration that King Henry VIII is the head of the church not the pope. His position replaced the position of the pope in England. Okay? This is the restraint of appeals. وكده وصلنا spring of 1533. Okay? In May بداية الصيف اهو 1533 Archbishop كان الأرشبيشوب اوف كانتربري. فاكرين توماس بيكت لما كنا بنقول أرشبيشوب اوف كانتربري؟ أرشبيشوب اوف كانتربري اسمه توماس كرانمر. توماس كرانمر heard a case or had a case against Catherine of Aragon, and he, الحكم بتاعه كان ايه؟ He judged that his marriage, King Henry, his marriage from Catherine of Aragon was invalid. حكمها بقى اداهم قرار بكده خلاص توماس كرانمر ان ايه خلاص الزواج بتاعهم invalid legally. كان الكلام ده in May 1533. اوكي؟ In June, the second month, June 1533, Anne was crowned. Anne Pauline was crowned. Anne Pauline was crowned in June 1533. On 7 September, she gave birth. 7 September 1533, she gave birth sorrowfully to a daughter, Elizabeth. The king, Elizabeth, 7 September, شهر 9, شهر العظماء ده, 7 September 1533, Elizabeth was born to be Queen Elizabeth after that, but in fact the king was disappointed. He wanted a male heir for his crown. So he was disappointed, in fact. Okay, in 1534, the parliament gave a new act for the accession of the throne. بيعمل ايه بقى؟ He punished Mary from being the second queen and gave everything to Elizabeth. الكلام ده في 1534, an act for the accession of the throne. واعلن ان ماري تعتبر ايه؟ illegal. We cannot be the following queen to the throne of England. على فكرة نفس الجريت مطر ده هيعمله مع إليزابيث بعد شوية when he would have a boy. Okay. الكلام ده 1534. In 1535-1536 يجي الجريت مطر بقى 1535 to 36, Cromwell, Thomas Cromwell as the general vicar, طبعا يعتبر the head of all the churches after the king and replaced Wolsey in everything. He imprisoned every churchman who preached against the king. أي واحد against the king should be imprisoned. Okay. الكلام ده حصل من 35 ل 36 and you can find that he dissolved, he and the king dissolved حل all the monasteries, كل الأديرة, all the shrines, shrine عارفة الضريح الأضرحة, and the monasteries, there would be no rites, خلاص, no sacraments at all, and began a revolution against the English church. وبدأ يحل كل الأديرة, المونستريز, dissolved the monasteries and the shrines. الكلام ده من 35 ل 36. طبعا who was against him كان توماس مور. توماس مور was against him, he was beheaded, حكم عليه بالإكسكيوشن, قطع رأسه. And then after him Bishop Fisher was against him, دول كانوا على رأس الناس اللي كانوا against the king and the dissolving of the monasteries. And also Bishop Fisher was beheaded, he was executed, and every man who was against the king and his decision was beheaded and was executed. طبعا a great revolution قامت ثورة against him in England, it summit pilgrimage of grace. Pilgrimage of grace. against the king, especially in the north. الكلام ده حصل كان في 36 in 1536. Belgian Marriage of Grace عبارة عن ايه؟ تعرفها الديفينيشن بتاعها a series of revolutions against the king, King Henry VIII, because of the dissolving of the monasteries and the shrines, the reformations of the church. Okay, دي Pilgrimage of Grace. Or the king طبعا bought these revolutions with the utmost savagery and oppression. الكلام ده كان وصل spring of 1537. He bought these revolutions with the utmost savagery and oppression. He executed about 180 persons, Catholic persons, because of these revolutions, and every churchman and everyone who accused him or who attacked him or even disagreed with his opinion. Okay, he in fact achieved victory against these revolutions, and no one can be a rebel against him or can make a revolution again against him. Okay, يبقى one matter بس إن to say to you that King Henry VIII married for about seven women or six women. He married three Catherine and two Anne and one Jane. ثلاثة كاثرين من زوجاته, two Anne, اتنين اسمهم Anne and one Jane. أول واحدة Catherine of Aragon اللي شفنا رحلته معاها. Number two Anne Boleyn. Number three Jane Seymour. Jane Seymour ودي اللي هتنجب لي طبعا ابنه الولد الوحيد جين سيمور, and then Anne, again Anne of Cleves, Catherine Howard, and the last one Catherine Barr. Catherine Howard and Anne Boleyn was الاثنين were executed by the king himself. They were beheaded قطع رأسهم. Even Thomas Cromwell إن شاء الله in the following lecture هنشوف نهايته على إيد هنري VIII. Also, he will be executed and he will be beheaded. Thank you so much.